If you know Python and have an interest in data engineering, data irrigation, or data science, I made up one of those jobs, there's no doubt you'll have come across a library called Pandas, which is a data analysis and manipulation module. I always refer to Pandas as Python's version of SQL or Excel. Well, last month I saw a Redditor by the name of Ugly Chihuahua, or Adam E. Rose as he's known on GitHub, create a GUI version of Pandas using PyQt5, and it's pretty damn cool. I'll leave a link to his GitHub in the video description, but it's github.com/AdamERose/PandasGUI. And I just wanted to spend this video exploring the awesome features of this library. To install it, just follow the instructions on his GitHub, which is basically a simple pip install and importing the library into your script. Then we'll load a data frame with, let's use a day's worth of Australian stock prices. Now onto the features. When we run it, we can see on the left we have a data frame name and its shape, which tells us the number of rows and columns. So that's 1,945 rows and 6 columns. In the middle, we have our data frame that we can modify using this GUI, which looks really similar to everyone's favorite, almost hated, spreadsheeting application. So let's check out the price of a company called Afterpay, since it's probably the hottest stock in Australia right now that I didn't buy. Sad face. I can go to edit at the top here and press find or control F and type in the ticker code, which is APT. Whoa, $78.95 back in August. I think it's now like $100. That's crazy. Anyway, if we wanted to update this to $100 and update other records, we can also export our modified data frame to CSV, which is pretty handy. And in this data frame view, you can also do a basic sort. And if you drag the filter tab into the data frame view so they're side by side, let's filter by some buy now, pay later companies. So code is equal to APT, or code is equal to Z1P for zip pay. Anyway, if we check the statistics tab, there's basically a describe view with just some basic profiling of our data. You know, data type, unique values, etc. And over to the next tab in Grapher, this is where you can make some really cool charts and graphs. And the awesome use case for this tab is, imagine you're in a huge meeting and you're the data guru in the team and someone's like, show me the breakdown of industries in the Australian Stock Exchange. And you have to create a graph on the fly, which can be pretty stressful, but it's really easy here. We just click a graph like pie, drag description into names, volume into values, and press finish. And that's pretty cool. We can see materials makes up 46% of the exchange by volume, followed by software and services. If you're wondering, the graphs are just made with Plotly, which you can see if you hover over the top right icon. Plotly is really cool, and in my opinion, it makes the best looking graphs compared to like Matplotlib, Seaborn, and Bokeh. It's also interactive as well, like Bokeh, which is really cool. You can hover over the bars and get some basic information from it. I really wanted to try Word Cloud, but that didn't seem to work for me. I think I have to do a pip install of Plotly or something. And then lastly, moving on to Reshaper, which we can use to create a pivot table. So let's add the industry description into index, volume into values, and click finish. And there we can see our data is aggregated. Now, if you're new to Pandas, I bet you're looking at this library like, Andrew, Excel does all of this anyway. What's so special about Pandas and Pandas GUI? Well, it's a good question. I mean, Excel is great for prototyping small data sets and for small businesses, but you only need to look at the UK, and this is no joke. Public Health England missed logging almost 16,000 coronavirus cases because they used an old template of Excel which only handles 65,000 records instead of the newer template which handles just over a million. Now that's pretty critical information to have in the middle of a health crisis, and it's important to realize that when it comes to bigger data sets, you have to consider moving away from Excel. You can't log an entire country's worth of data on a spreadsheet, mate. Now, although Pandas GUI can display more than a million rows, when I tried loading bigger datasets like 60 to 600 meg, it would open, but it was noticeably slower, like 10 to 30 seconds to load instead of like 1 second. Now, you could look at this and go, Andrew, that's too slow, but hey, have you tried loading 600 meg of data in Excel? It takes anywhere between 2 to north of 20 minutes. It's creeping slow, it's not graceful at handling more than the spreadsheet limit of 1,048,576 rows. So even though it takes a while, hey, at least Pandas GUI can load over 1 million rows, and it can only get faster with future releases. Anyway, that's it for this one. I'm really looking forward to the future updates, and fingers crossed, one day it can be the free Tableau alternative. Please check out Adam E. Rose's GitHub, as he's the author of the software. See you in the next one.